Wouldn't you like to follow the traces of how mankind spread? Our hominins have been living on this land for millions of years. But it wasn't noticed until our ancestors tried to escape from Africa. Astonishingly, scientific research has shown that the 7.5 billion people who occupy the Earth today are the descendants of a woman who lived 200,000 years ago in Eastern Africa. Scientists call her mitochondrial Eve. Will you not follow along with me? The traces of how mankind spread by following the footsteps of the descendants of mitochondrial Eve? Mitochondrial Eve was born and lived in East Africa about 200,000 years ago. First, let's go to the place where she was born and raised through Google Earth. You can see a huge lake and a wide meadow. Lake Victoria and Serengeti Plains. You can also see Mount Kilimanjaro. The surface area of Lake Victoria is 59,947 square meters. It is a huge lake that is 38 times larger than London, 99 times larger than Seoul, 76 times larger than Singapore, and 339 times larger than Washington, D.C. The Serengeti ecosystem is a geographical region in Africa, spanning northern Tanzania. The protected area within the region includes approximately 30,000 square kilometers of land, including the Serengeti National Park and several game reserves. The name Serengeti is often said to be derived from the word Seringet in the Maasai language, Ma, meaning endless plains. Mount Kilimanjaro is a dormant volcano in Tanzania. It has three volcanic cones, Kibo, Mwanzi, and Shira. It is the highest mountain in Africa and the highest single freestanding mountain in the world, 5,895 meters above sea level. Because of its shrinking glaciers and ice fields, which are projected to disappear between 2025 and 2035, it has been the subject of many scientific studies. So far, we have looked at the region where the common mother of mankind, mitochondrial Eve, may have lived. This is where her descendants lived as hunter-gatherers. It may seem peaceful, but it is also a place of fierce life. At that time, climate change caused the prey to migrate, and it is presumed that they moved along with the prey. Now you are looking at their migration routes from 150,000 to 100,000 years ago. L is mitochondrial Eve, and LX are her descendants. Letters are human mitochondrial DNA haplogroup, arrows are migration paths. The number in the upper left corner of the screen is the estimated age. How would you have known this? We have DNA that is inherited only through females. It's called mitochondrial DNA. We can trace back this mitochondrial DNA to find out who our ancestors were. But why is mitochondrial DNA only inherited through females? Doesn't the man have it? Of course, men also have mitochondrial DNA. However, a man's mitochondrial DNA is not passed on to offspring. Let's find out why. Mitochondrial DNA is only a small portion of the DNA in a eukaryotic cell. Most of the DNA can be found in the cell nucleus and, in plants and algae, also in plastids such as chloroplasts. Sperm from a man's body goes on a long journey to find an egg deep in the woman's body to obtain descendants. Among tens of thousands of sperm, only one sperm is selected and fertilization takes place. You have experienced your first victory here, so you should be proud of being born. During fertilization, not all parts of the sperm enter the egg. The tail part is left and only the head couple gate is inserted and fertilized. Herein lies the secret that men's mitochondrial DNA is not inherited. Man's mitochondrial DNA resides in the tail. This principle has only recently been used in the study of human history. By 1985, data from the mtDNA of 145 women of different populations, and of two cell lines, HeLa and GM3043, derived from an African American and A. Kung respectively, were available. The study published on January 1, 1987. The published conclusion was that all current human mtDNA originated from a single population from Africa, at the time dated to between 140,000 and 200,000 years ago. After this thesis, DNA was extracted from ancient human fossils and analyzed. The map used in this video was created by referring to the results of direct mapping of these research results and data from Wikipedia. Click the link in the description below to view the mtDNA mapping results by year. Now, let's watch the migration path of the mitochondrial Eve descendants again. About 60 to 80,000 years ago, A renewed expansion repopulated Africa with L2 and L3 mtenotypes. About 50 to 60,000 years ago, L3 type African moved to Southwest Asia. All non-Africans are today descended from either M or N types, both descended from an Africa L3 type. The group leaving Africa must have been very small, given that only two mtena lineages survived. The M and N types, which left India about 600,000 years ago, arrive in Australia around 50,000 to 40,000. This was the Ice Age, and the seas near Indonesia were all land. It is called Sunda land. It is presumed that they crossed the sea by constructing a raft near present-day Bali. They were the first navigators of mankind. At this time, between New Guinea and Australia was land. Some of the M and N types that migrated to Australia between 50,000 and 40,000 years ago, change direction and head towards East Asia along the eastern coast. Crossing the M and N type Eurasian grasslands that lived in Western Asia and heading to East Asia. Many races are born in Western Asia.
I, U, H, V types go to Europe.
At this time, Europe was inhabited by Neanderthals. Type X leaves West Asia a little later and heads for Siberia. It was a very cold ice age. I will introduce the life of our ancestors during the Ice Age through another video. The M and N types, derived from L3, served as the basis of mitochondrial DNA for today's offspring. Currently, Europeans do not have M-type mitochondrial DNA, which is unusual.
Between 40,000 and 30,000 years, a group with mitochondrial DNA of type A, B, and F derived from type N appears in East Asia. At the same time, C, G, and D types appear.
C and Y types also appear. They have M type as their ancestor. Type D advances to Japan via the Korean Peninsula. The last glacial maximum period begins in 33,000. LGM lasts as long as 25,600. During this time, large continental ice sheets existed in Europe and North America. The sea level was also 120 meters lower than it is today. The west coast of the Korean Peninsula and the Bering Sea were connected by land.
25,000 years ago in Asia, A, B, C, and D types spread to the east of Siberia.
The X type from Western Europe also arrives here. They lived here in the coldest time. They begin to cross the Bering Sea in search of a warm place where the sun rises. It was the end of the Ice Age. It is estimated that a few types A and D crossed the Bering Sea 20,000 years ago. Around 15,000, a type arrives in Alaska in groups. This is the time when the Earth's temperature rose after the last ice age. Sea levels would rise again, but the Bering Sea would have been covered in ice. The period between 14,690 and 12,890 before was the Bolling-Alert warming period. The Nordic Fennoscandian ice sheet begins to melt.
This is the period when I, U, V, J, H, and V types began to migrate to Northern Europe. Types A, B, C, D, X, who lived in Alaska, moved to South America.
Some of them arrived in South America 12,000 years ago. At that time, there was a huge continental ice sheet on the North American continent. The Laurentide ice sheet to the east and the Kerguelen ice sheet to the west coast of North America covered the continent. But how were they able to move south? Recent research suggests that an ice-free corridor opened between two ice sheets before 12,600.
Types A, B, C and D traveled along this route over 1,000 years, reaching Central and South America.
The Earth's temperature begins to rise after the end of the Ice Age. Then, between 12,900 and 11,700, the temperature of the Earth's cloud suddenly drops. This period is called the Younger Dryas period. It was found that this was because Lake Agassiz in North America burst and flowed into Hudson Bay, affecting the thermohaline circulation system. During this period, Type B migrates to the Philippines and the island of Borneo. Some of the B types who lived here moved to Madagascar before 1500, and migrated to Polynesia including New Zealand before 1000. So far it has been a long journey of 200,000 years along the mitochondrial Eve. Shall we summarize the results of our trip? The first L type was found in Africa. Type N lived in Western Asia, East Asia, and Australia. M type was widely distributed, and can be found in the Arabian Peninsula, Sahel, India, East Asia, and Australia. Type R was found in Central and Eastern Africa, Western Asia, and India. U-type existed in India, Western Asia, and Northern Europe. Type I lived in Western Asia and Northern Europe. T-type can be found in Northern Caspian Sea and Western Europe. Type H can be found around the Iberian Peninsula, Northern Europe, and the Black Sea. Type V is found in Northwestern Africa, the Iberian Peninsula, and Northern Europe. Type C can be found in East Asia, Siberia, Central America, and the Amazon region. Type A is found in East Asia, North America, and Greenland. Type B can be found in East Asia, Southeast Asia, North America, South America, Madagascar, New Zealand, and the Polynesian Islands. Type F exists in Southeast Asia. Type D is found in Alaska, the eastern United States, and the Amazon region of South America.
Types Y, Z, and X lived elsewhere, appearing in Siberia and North America.
Q and P types appear in Irian Jaya, Indonesia, and Papua New Guinea. If you look at the current distribution location for each type, it appears like a map on the screen. Thanks for watching for a long time. Starting with mitochondrial Eve, by tracking the occurrence and extinction of nomads, we have just started mapping on the map. Why don't you take a nomad trip with a map with me? Please subscribe, like, share, and set notifications.